All right, we got one of the last Gandhis up because they're bumping it and it's shaking from the wind. Winds have picked up like they called for, and I'm getting in Pete's snowboard track to help get across here because we've got a good 5 inches now, and it feels real good under the ski. I'm out with Pete, Joe, Cary. Joe's got the music going. I think we're gonna hit polar bear. And then we're gonna hit the Ursa outside once or twice. And by then, maybe the boss man will be here. So we've got -6 and the winds are up to 40 now. We've got a -14 with the wind chill. Probably gonna go lower, even lower than that. We're gonna get drift. You can see them right here. All right? And we have to be careful. We don't hit one. And they've still got the grizz closed. We're waiting for the 2 feet there. Look over to my right, nothing. We've got March 14th and a nor'easter has hit Vermont. Out with the early access crew. And there goes Pete, he's got the good whack. And now we've got Harbor Chop right here. This is Harbor Chop that I'm dealing with. And yeah, I'm hitting it. As you can see, and thank God for the mantras. You know, the mantra or the Alon ripstick would do well in here. Because everybody's been here and hit it. So we're just dealing with some harbor chop. Just crossing lines. But I keep moving, keep myself moving, try to keep my hands balanced, because that's tough skiing right there. Cary's trying to hunt some clean stuff, but it's just not happening. So another trick is to get in somebody else's track and just stay there, but then we're right down on the ice. Or the hard pack. So, hey, stop by Ski House, get tuned, get fitted, and then get to Strat. Wow. Whoa, that was tough skiing in there.